Hey, let's be honest. Being creative when you're a streamer can be really tough, especially when you have to think about things like overlays or emotes and badges and graphics and yes, even panels. But it's okay because things just got a whole lot easier thanks to Nerd or Die, because they redid, revamped, and updated their UI so you can have better looking panels on your Twitch page and yes, even your mixer, and they look better than ever. And I'm gonna show you everything you need to know about it so that way your channel can look very pretty. Let's go. Hey all, Wild Free Games here, helping you become bigger and better. If this is your first time here and you need help growing and improving your channel, good news is for you, that's what this channel is all about. Make sure you hit that big red subscribe button down below and tick that bell so you know when my videos go live for you. Nerd or Die is a great resource for paid and free, and their free panel maker is an awesome resource that you can use. And luckily for you and for me, they made an update to make it even better. So I'm gonna show you everything on how to make a panel from beginning to end, how to save it, and even how to load it into Twitch. So that way you're good and go to create a beautiful looking channel by the end of this video. Alrighty, let's go. Open up your web browser and go to nerdordie.com, and in the top nav bar, you will see resources and Twitch panel maker. Go ahead and click on this. Just to let you know, you can always click through the link down below in the video description. It'll take you right to this page that you're gonna see right here. When you first get to the page, you will see some awesome examples of some panels that you can make with the free panel maker. So let's have a little fun and make a couple of panels down here. Now, when you first get to customize, you're gonna see all the general settings you can do. First, we have text, which you can put in anything. Let's make an About Me panel real easily. Over to the right side is where you got your font family. If you know what font you want to use, you can simply just type it in by clicking on custom font, but feel free to click and see all the different examples, and they will populate over on the right hand side for you to see whatever best style is for you and your stream. Once you've picked a font that works for you, you have the alignment of the icon. You can either align it on the left hand side or align it on the right hand side. Pick which one you think is best for you and your style again. And also you can stylize the font by italicizing it if you need to. Below alignment, you will see font weight, which essentially makes it more bolder or more skinnier. Next to that, you have font size, which makes the font bigger or smaller. I like to fill out the whole entire panel, but it may be different for you. So again, pick and choose what's best for you. Underneath text, you have the ability to disable the icon if you want to display text only. This way you could really center punch if you really, really wanted to. On the far right side is the icon scale, where you can make your icon either smaller or bigger, depending on, again, what feels best for you. If you'd like to change the icon, go down to Icon Picker, and you can select any one of the pre-selected icons that they have here to make it nice and easy for you. I'm gonna go with this nice little crown here since I think I'm king. If you'd like to upload any of your own icons, you can do so. You just have to make sure that it's a PNG. The next tab we have is Effects, where you get to enable or disable the shadow effect, which goes around the icon here. You can also pick what angle you'd like to display it at, which is really, really nice because you can give it a nice little personal touch here. Below that, you have the border width of what goes around the entire panel itself. So that way you can make it stand out a little bit more depending again on your style. If you do give it a border, you can also choose the radius of how smooth the corners are going to be. The next tab we have is colors, where it allows you to change the color of your text. Just simply click on any one of the rainbow colors you have here. You can do the same thing with the icon if you so choose so. You can pick any color that you need, as well as change the text background color if you want it to stand out on something different. So it really gives you a lot of free range. You can also colorize the icon if you want, so that way you can stand out a little bit more and have some fun. And if you'd like to change the border, that's where you can do so on the effects panel. The last tab we have is positioning, where you get to change the panel height, which will essentially make it skinnier or a little bit taller. You can also change your text position, so this way you can balance things a lot better depending if you have an icon or not. You can also offset your icon to put in any position that you may need to do. And that is how you make your own beautiful panel. So the panel I made right now is super fugly, but it shows you how you can adjust and change and customize pretty much everything within this panel. Now, let me make a really clean and good looking one and show you how to export it and load it into your Twitch panels so you're good and ready to go. So now that we've got our pretty panel here, you can double check to see how it looks on Twitch Dark, Twitch Light mode, and also how it will look on Mixer. When you're happy with what you got, all you have to do is click the Save Panel Image and it'll download to your download folder. Now, just really quick, people used to always complain in the comment section about this panel maker, about how it would never download. And I would assume that's because depending on what browser you're on, it may have an issue exporting out, or you may have some type of blocker on it. Now, I'm using this on Chrome, so I know it works on Chrome. So my advice to you is use Chrome. Second bit of advice is get off Internet Explorer, but that's just a life tip. To load any of the panels that you made from Nerd or Die's panel maker, all you need to do is log into your account on Twitch and go to your own channel and scroll down below the video player where you will see Edit Panel. Go ahead and toggle this on and scroll all the way to the bottom where you will see the plus mark. Tick on this and here is where we can add our panel. Just click and drag and load your panel and resize it and click done. And now you can submit it and make sure when you submit, you scroll all the way back to the top here and click off the toggle so that way it saves your settings. Now you can see we've got an awesome panel here that looks beautiful on our channel page. I'm gonna be honest with you, this is a pretty dope, awesome resource that you should be using right now. So thanks Nerd or Die for allowing people to have really awesome panels for free. And now there's no reason why your channel should look basic. At the very least, you should have some really clean and consistent looking panels so that way you can make your channel look better. I'm so tired of basic channels and this will allow you to get out of the basic zone. Now, Nerd or Die also has some paid packages that you can really take your stream to the next level. I recommend checking them out. I can't remember if I have an affiliate link or not, but if I do, I'll make sure to put it down below. But regardless, I'll put a link to their store down below so that we can shop and browse to see if there's a style that works for you. Now, if you wanna do even more customized panels and you wanna really flex that creative muscle that you got, I would really recommend taking a look at Canva, which I've done a video of that you can check out right here. It's a really cool free program again that allows you to create whatever your little heart desires. I really recommend checking out because you're just gonna love it. Until next time, my name's Wild for Games, helping you become bigger and better. And as always, my friends, take care and of course, peace.